Welcome back, Wellness Warriors, to the Entheogen Explorer channel. I'm Caitlin Thompson, and in this video, I'm going to talk to you about lecithin. Yes, lecithin, that mysterious and strange food additive ingredient that's in all of your chocolate, almond milk, baked goods, and buttery spreads. Turns out lecithin is actually pretty healthy for you, especially your brain. Finally, a food additive that's not toxic for us. So what on earth is lecithin? Lecithin is a general term to describe the yellow fatty substance that is derived from sunflowers, soy, and eggs that is ampophilic. Ampophilic is just a fancy term that means it's both soluble in water and fat. Because lecithin has this unique property of dissolving in water and oil, it's used in a number of sauces, baked goods, nut milks, and other products as an emulsifier to help stop the separation of the fats and the water-soluble ingredients in the mix. Lecithin contains a number of phosphatidylcholine and phospholipids. Now, phospholipids are important components of our cell membranes. Phosphatidylcholine is a rich source of choline, which is an important nutrient for the production of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. Choline supplementation has been found to improve fatty liver disease, reduce LDL or bad cholesterol levels, decrease anxiety, and also decrease mania and psychosis in those with bipolar disorder and schizophrenia. Choline is also important for balancing homocysteine pathways in the body and acts as a methylation donor, promoting methylation, which is important for neurotransmitter production, cell detoxification, gene transcription, and maintenance of cell membranes. Because the vast majority of the tissue in our brains is fatty substance, choline is especially important for maintaining brain cell membranes. As I mentioned earlier, choline is an essential building block for making the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is fundamental for mood, memory, and cognition. It's also important for activating the parasympathetic nervous system response, which is basically the rest and digest or relaxation response. Low levels of acetylcholine have been linked to schizophrenia, and supplementation by choline has been found to have an antipsychotic effect and reduce mania and psychosis in those with schizophrenia. Studies have also observed that anxiety is associated with low levels of choline. Supplementation with choline was able to positively reduce these levels of anxiety in subjects. Studies show that consuming lecithin results in increased levels of choline in the blood, in the brain, and increased levels of acetylcholine. But too much of a good thing is also possible. You don't want to have too much choline. Some studies suggest that excessive amounts of choline may prompt depression symptoms in susceptible individuals. Now, other studies also look at low levels of choline being associated with depression. So, like anything, balance and dosage is probably key to finding that sweet spot with choline. You may also wonder, what if I'm allergic to soy or egg or sunflower, or worried about GMO residues in my food? Well, luckily, lecithin is so refined and concentrated by the end of its processing that there's virtually no trace amounts of any protein or DNA fragments left in the end product. Therefore, you're unlikely to have any sort of allergenic response or exposure to GMO toxic protein fragments or DNA. So how much lecithin should you take in a day? Well, like everything, that largely depends on the individual and what their biotype is, how much meat or eggs they're eating, and what their activity level is. It's best to start low and experiment and see how your body responds. I recommend starting with maybe 0.5 gram, and then you can go up to 2 grams a day of lecithin, and just listen to your body and explore and experiment and see what works best for you. While you can buy lecithin in capsules, I actually really like the taste, and I like to just eat it as granules. It's sort of like this strangely satisfying tiny little granules of nutritious wax. So in summary, lecithin and its phosphatidylcholine show evidence for improving brain health, mood, memory, anxiety, liver health, cholesterol, and detoxification pathways. So next time you see lecithin on the ingredients list in your chocolate bar, you can feel good knowing that you're getting a little extra phosphatidylcholine in your diet that day, making your chocolate healthy for you. If you're interested in trying lecithin out for yourself, I've included a link in the description below. It's an affiliate link to a product that I recommend, and I do get a little kickback if you decide to purchase through that link, and no added cost to you. If you're seeking nutritional interventions to maintaining mood and brain health, be sure to check out Entheogen's products on our online store. There's a link below if you want to get 20% off your first purchase. And if you dug this video, think about subscribing because you'll love getting the weekly updates of videos that I release every week at Monday, 6 p.m. PST. Love you guys. Smile on, my warriors. Mwah.